Hello everyone, in this video I will go over my solution for the problem named permutations and primes taken from today's Codeforces round. This is an excellent problem which will teach you about the max operator and about how to find prime numbers using the max operator. So we are basically given a permutation of length n. We need to find a permutation of length n which has the maximum primality, where the primality is defined as the number of subarrays such that the max of the subarray is a prime number. So we basically need to maximize number of subarrays such that the max of the subarray is a prime number. And in order to do that, we need to look at what exactly the max operation does. So in order to understand the max operation, let's look at a few examples. So let's say that we have a subarray which is, let's say that the subarray includes some numbers. So notice that our permutation will contain the numbers 1 to n, and your max should be the smallest positive integer which does not occur in the subarray. So you're not including 0, so you start off with 1. So let's say you have 1 in the array, and then let's say you have some other elements 3, 4, 5, then the max of this thing is 2, which is a prime number because 2 does not appear in this array. It's the smallest positive numbers does not appear on this array. Let's say that, however, if you start from something like 2, 3, 4, 5, then the max of this thing is 1. And if you start off 1, 2, 4, 5, dot, 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 then the max of this thing is 3. So in general, you can see that if you want the max to be a prime number, then you need to ensure that we have the first p minus 1 numbers. So ensure we have 1 to p minus 1. And then p is not present. P does not exist in this subarray. In this way, we know that the max of the subarray will be a prime number. So this seems a bit complicated to ensure this, but if you look for small prime numbers such as 2 and 3, you will realize that you basically, if you want the max to be equal to 2, this means that you basically want to ensure that 1 is there and then you have some bigger numbers. So in this case, the max is equal to 2. And if you want the max to be equal to 3, this means that you basically want the numbers 1, 2 to be there, and then you want some bigger numbers. And the optimal solution, which ensures that the max is 2 in most cases, or the max is 3 in most cases, and which also ensures that the max is not 1. So if you try to come up with a construction, you'll see that if you put 1 in the beginning, it's suboptimal, because the max of anything after 1 will be equal to 1. So max is equal to 1. So this is suboptimal. And similarly, putting 1 in the end is suboptimal, because you'll get all this entire range of elements with max 1, which is not prime. That's why the optimal solution is to put 1 in a position where it always gets included. So always include 1. Try to always include 1 in a subarray. So include 1 in the maximum number of subarrays. And if you want to include 1 in the maximum number of subarrays, then you will place 1 in the middle. So place 1 in the middle of the array. And this is actually something which you will also notice from the answers to the examples. Regardless of what the construction is, 1 always comes out to be near the middle of the array. And the intuition behind that is you want to ensure that the max is not 1. And the max will be 1 only when 1 is not included in a subarray. So since you want to maximize the number of prime maxes, you want to ensure that one is in the middle of the array so that the max is always like 2 or 3. Now, to ensure that, so now you know that the array is something like 1 is in the middle, and then you have some elements, and you have some elements. And the key idea is that if you want to ensure that the max is always 2 or 3, you need to make sure that 2 or 3 does not appear anywhere here. So if 2 or 3 does not appear anywhere here, then the max will turn out to be 2 over here. And if 2 does appear somewhere, then the max of this entire thing will turn out to be 3. And that's why if you ensure that these gaps are not 2 or 3, and if you simply place 2 over here and 3 over here, then you'll always ensure that the max is equal to 2 or 3 for a large number of subarrays. So any subarray which includes the center and which does not include the endpoints has a max of 2. And if it includes this left endpoint, it has a max of 3. And this is actually all that is required. The remaining elements, you can fill them in increasing order. So you can place 4, 5, 6, and then you can place 1, and then you can place like 7, 8, 9. And in the end, you place 3. So the only real condition is that 2 should be in the beginning, 1 should be in the middle, 3 should be in the end, and the remaining elements can be in increasing order in the middle. And though I've explained a very rough intuitive process behind why we do this, it includes 3 main ideas. The first main idea is that you want 1 to be in the middle so that you're always including 1 in a subarray. And you also want the max to be 2 or 3, which is why you'll place 2 or 3 at the end so that 2 or 3 is never included in a subarray. And the remaining elements can actually be anywhere, and this construction actually does get accepted. So now I'll show you the code which implements the same process of filling up the numbers in this array. So in the code, you can see that I start off with printing 2. Then I repeatedly increase the elements and print them. If the number is 3, we want to print it in the end. So if I is n, we print 3 in the end. If I is a middle element, we place 1 in the middle. And if I is the first element, we print 2. The remaining elements can be printed in increasing order. And you can verify that this code does get accepted. So I hope you like this problem and my solution. If you have any issues in any part of the solution, do leave them in the comments down below. And if you like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. Thank you.